Yeah. Microphone check. Microphone check. 1, 2, 1, 2. It's truly yours. Yours truly, Carlo Banger, back at it again with another episode of Making Noise in the Kitchen. Today we're gonna do something pretty cool. We're gonna do something quick and simple. This is a clams with some bacon and some dashi. It's just a dope clams recipe that you can easily do at the crib. Start off with the bacon to keep everybody melt. I mean the butter, excuse me. This butter, swirl it around, you know what I'm saying? This is our base. We wanna, you know what I'm saying, pull some flavors out of some things. So right now we're gonna throw some shallots in there and some garlic, and really get the fragrance coming out of these bad boys. You want this thing, this is going to be the underlying flavor of what we got going on, you know what I'm saying? So saute those down, make sure them things is nice and translucent, you know what I'm saying? Once you smell that fragrance, then you know what I'm saying, you go about your business, you know what I mean? But right here we got to add some pepper flake, and we're going to throw some green onions in here, all right? This is going to give it a nice little... A nice little little sourness. That green onion, you could never go wrong with. You know what I'm saying? This really pushes off some good flavor. So in the back, I want to take this off the heat and throw some tequila on there. So bang, we can flambe this thing, all right? Now the tequila, that's the underlying little tropical kind of hint that you gonna get from the nice, you know, cactus and all that that's in the tequila. But let this thing burn off, you know what I mean? And then you can continue on with yourself. Throw these clams in here. These are beautiful clams. They're closed. This is the start of our process. Throw that in there, and this is when they're gonna start to feel the effect. Cause right here we're gonna throw this dashi stock in there. I can't just leave this alone with just what I just put in there alone. I had to put some dashi stock in there. This dashi stock is gonna bring it to another level. This is kind of like the oriental flavor. It's pretty much just a fish stock with some seaweed and shit like that. You know what I mean? But this is what's gonna give it that that seafood taste that we looking for, but not too crazy. You know what I mean? Yeah, so just let those things sit in there while everything bubble up and cover them. You know what I mean? Everything's gonna steam, and then boom, they're gonna open up. You don't wanna overcook these things. They're gonna open up and just let it just seep in a little bit of the flavor, alright? Throw some breadcrumb in there because we want still a little bit of kind of consistency in these bad boys. Plus it's like along the lines of an oreganato or a clam cecina or something like that, you know what I mean? Just with a little couple more different kicks, you know what I mean? So right here is when we're going to add our bacon. I had some bacon in the back in the oven going on, made it nice and crispy. Chopped it down and throw it in there. Now you got a hint of smokiness. Come on, man. That's flavor for your ear right there. You feel me? Season the taste, you know what I mean? Throw a little bit more salt, you know, if you need to. You know what I mean? And throw whatever kind of other things you want to throw in there. But this is my way. This is banging right here. This is a banger way. Alright, so now we gotta, do a nice little presentation. Of course, presentation is key, you know what I mean? And throw these things face up. Alright, the reason why we're putting these clams in this bowl face up is because, watch, you're gonna see in a minute. But make sure all of them are faced up. Don't have them facing down because, like I said, these pretty much are flavor catchers, you feel me? So throw them down nicely. Make sure your plate is nice and not dirty. And now throw some more bacon in there. Now this isn't the bacon that we just cooked down, but just some more crispy bacon, add a little texture, and throw some grated palm cheese, top right here with the sauce that you just made, and let me tell you, the palm cheese is gonna melt a little bit in there, and now you got just a flavor going on right here, you know what I'm saying? This is definitely dope for a little snack, or you can make it the main event, you know what I mean? Garnish with a little bit of green onion. Make that thing look pretty, and also that's another. We have the cooked green onion. We took the flavor out of it. Now with the freshness of the green onion and every bite mixed with the bacon and all that, it's going to be amazing. Throw a little bit of lime juice. I did it. I wanted to change it up. You know what I'm saying? Usually they put lemon juice. I want to throw a little bit of lime juice. See where that thing get us. So now, you know, this is it. This is the top end. Whatever, some smoked paprika, and look at that bad boy. That thing looking delicious. And man, I guarantee you gonna get far in places and in life. Paul, excuse me for all that spitting. You get far in life with a dish like this. Make a noise in the kitchen, bitch.